guys, good morning. It's morning here in the Philippines and I am now actually in my duck yard. It's my duck farm. It's located here in the municipality of Gipos, and this is some 50 to 60 miles away from Zamboanga City. And I am now here just to check this farm. I actually started this 2 years ago, and in here there are actually 2,000 heads of ducks. I think there are 400 males and 1,600 females, and this business is focused on egg production and balut production. You know, balut is an egg incubated for 18 days, which has already a chick inside, and these are sold in the streets of major cities like Zamboanga City and Pagadian City, and also in the town proper you can also see some people selling baluts. And this is a good business actually, because the cost of this balut is 18 pesos. So if you are making eggs, incubating eggs into balut, you will earn 10 pesos more than selling the eggs. So I will show you now the mechanics on how to operate this kind of business, and I hope this will encourage other people, especially those that are also planning to engage this kind of business. This is really a good business, and you can get some tips out of this video only here at Dexter's World. Yes, I'm feeding my ducks with the pellet here. There are 2,000 ducks here. And the ratio is 1:3, 3 females and 1 male. And they are now producing eggs. And as of the moment, I can harvest more than 1,000 or less in a day. So this is how lucrative this business gonna be. If you can just have the right techniques and the correct procedure, you can always have a lucrative earnings. But of course, you have to consider all the do's and don'ts. So that is why I'm sharing this to you, so that you can also have an idea on how to operate this kind of business. As you can see here at my back, I can say this is the swimming pool of these ducks here. This is very important. You have a water, but the technology now is somewhat different from the old technology, because the old concept was that you have to have a lagoon or a big pond for you to be able to raise these ducks. But the new technology, you can just put a shallow cement like a fish pond here, and then they are already contented with this kind of bath pool, and they got the feeling that they are already in the big pond, in the big lagoon, or in the river. So this technology is actually new, and you can just adapt this. It's a 3 by 10 meters a pool, somewhat a pool here, for them to be able to take a bath. So they will take a bath at any time, so you have to make sure that the water, you, you have to make sure that the water is always clean. Because if this water becomes dirty, they will not take a bath anymore. See, that will also affect the egg production. So every now and then, you have to put some new water. You will drain the old water, and you will replace it with new one, and they will again take a bath. So this is actually the technique. You have to flush out the old water and put in the new one. So I am now collecting the eggs, guys, here. And yesterday I collected 1,500 eggs, and I hope I can collect the same amount of eggs here. So look at the eggs, guys, here. You have to be careful because underneath this rice hull, you can still collect some eggs. So be careful, it will not trample upon the eggs. See that? Plenty. Plenty of eggs. Blessing. This is a blessing. So I am expecting five pails for this morning. You see, I broke the egg because I did not know that underneath there are still eggs there. So very careful when you are collecting the eggs because you might break the eggs here. So this one, I broke it, and this is already 8 peso. So this is now the process. After collecting these eggs, you have to wipe them with clean cloth, and then I am going to put this inside the incubator for 16 days or 18 days. As these eggs develop, we will harvest it at the 18th day and sell these eggs. We call it in the local term balut to some people, and then they will cook this one and sell this on the streets. That is why we have so many balut vendors. If you can visit Zamboanga City or other place in the Philippines, you will always enjoy eating this balut. It's an egg that is incubated for 18 days, and you can have a taste of small ducklings inside the egg, and it's very delicious, and it's very good source of protein. So that is why I said that this business really is a good business if you will know the techniques. And the techniques that I'm giving to you, the rice hull, the egg production, the swimming pool, the area where they can take a bath, is actually very important. This hen was able to lay eggs while sleeping. Look at that. So this is how egg production really goes. Okay. Every 2 a.m., these ducks, hens, will lay eggs until 5 a.m. in the morning. And the eggs laid largely depend on the amount of food they eat. Because if they will not be fed enough, some of them will skip laying eggs. So that is why it's very important to feed them with enough food and the right food. And that's the technique. Because if they are not being fed fully, they will not also lay eggs every day. So very important. And the ratio to be able to have a good production and high fertility, the ratio is one male against three females. And of course, your play should be something like tranquil, because these hens, if disturbed by the noise of the vehicle coming, they are also scared and the egg production also will be affected. Inside the incubator. So this is gonna be incubated for 18 days, and after 18 days we will unload this one, and this is already the so-called balut, locally known as balut, incubated eggs. So the complete incubation is actually 28 days before these eggs are hatched, but we are harvesting at 18 days for balut purposes. So now there are people coming here and buying the 18-day incubated eggs.